Hey, who? Oh, it's you, Ken. Man, we're not even. We're just getting done with hair and makeup. Hold on one second. Hold on. Here's hair and makeup right here. All right, we're done. Hair and makeup is over. How you doing? We're back here at Rock the House. And this is it, this is the final day. We went and we listed a couple days ago. You guys are gonna get to see the after now. Now hopefully, what happens here is we get to pan back and see a lot of the before pictures. We can compare some of the afters. You're not gonna even think it's the same house. Everybody who sees this house thinks we bulldozed it and started over, which we practically did. So let's go on. Let's see the kitchen here first. That's pretty much the main deal. The kitchen, the master bedroom, master bathroom are just totally awesome. So let's check it out. Here we go. We got every single cabinet tore out. This wall were tore out to the studs here. Ceiling was removed, raised up. We put this is a genuine tin ceiling, a real tin ceiling in here, which you probably never seen that in a residence. You've seen it in some bars, your favorite places, like maybe some TGI Friday places and things like that. All the cabinets are ebony, shaker, soft close, of course. We did it, switched it up with the island. The island is a white, just to switch it up. Quartz countertops, leather finished, on the island in the bar area. We got a little bar up above, so a couple seating positions here. Floating hood. All appliances were Bosch, and we did a Sub-Zero fridge, built-in nice 48-inch Sub-Zero. All the lighting in here has been redone, all LED lighting now. The floor has been done completely. Throughout the house, it's done. It's an engineered, true hardwood floor. Now, this floor is made by Armstrong. It's made to be clicked. And you've been in the houses where people put the click together the floor and you walk on it and it feels like it's moving or it feels like it's floating and stuff. That drives me crazy. So, we did something different in here. It's a click together floor. We glued it down everywhere. It took a lot more work, but this floor feels as solid as like the street outside now. So, and there's not a seam in it. From the moment we come in through the garage, through the living room, kitchen, all the way down the hallway, and to the end. We didn't have a single seam, a threshold, or anywhere in here. So, just to give you some highlights in the kitchen here, we got this island. I repurposed the outside siding that was on the house to begin with. And what I did is here, put it in the living room, and I used it on the wall in there, recut it up, fit it on there, stain it different. You don't even recognize it now. So it's actual 60-year-old wood, not barn wood, but it was on a building. Looks like barn wood or stuff. And reused it, and it now looks, I mean, people pay big bucks for this stuff now. So check out the dining room. We expanded the dining room, removed this wall right here. You'll see that in a previous episode. Here's what we did with the post. We had to leave the post in, so we thought, well, what can we do to it and dress it up? So we faced it with the same stuff we used on the fireplace, and we say we use the ledger board or ledger rock on the outside of the house, on the post, on the fireplace. You won't see it yet, but we're putting a fire pit in. That's the one thing I'm gonna be doing afterwards. And we'll show that as a later thing. So, you wanna come down the hallway here? We're looking here. We'll come back to the living room. Oh, but wait. Oh.
Who's that over there? Mariah.
So Mariah's in the living room here. She's being such a good girl. Mariah. Hi.
Mariah. Hey.
YouTube.
Oh, boy. Did you drug her or something? Jesus, said a word.
Just bribed her to be quiet.
So here's that wall right here we're talking about. We repurposed the siding that was on the front of the house, cut it up, restained it, put it on the wall, and look what you got. And it looks awesome. Fireplace, completely redone. It's a wood burning, and gas fireplace could be used as both. We use the leather finished granite again here. Kind of a different touch, you don't see it too often. All these walls here in the living room have been done with the Venetian plaster, which I think we did a video on that too. So we had a video of us doing the Venetian plaster. We put a crown molding all the way around here. Did all the baseboards, casing, and crown all in a black. You see it done white, you see it done whites, grays, all through these flip houses. The same finishes, the white shaker, the Calcutta countertops and stuff. So you will see none of that here. This is all custom one-off stuff in here. So let's go down the hallway, check it out. You can go back to where the living room was when we started and check it out. So we're coming down the hallway here. Used to be a closet here. Now that closet is part of the bedroom. And let's go into the first bathroom that wasn't even a bathroom before. This is a part of the master bedroom before. And so it's a guest bathroom and a bathroom. It's a full bath too, so not a half bath. And this one turned out pretty cool too. We used a porcelain tile, stainless steel, brushed nickel everywhere. The accents are all the red. Now, I got to let you know that all the staging in this house done, you'll see it all staged throughout this house. This was 100% done by mom. And well, you can go back to who mom was and show her. Mom did all of this stuff. Every little bit of staging, all the decorations, all the accents, every single bit of this was her idea. Came down from Minnesota 3 different times to help me out on this. We thought it was gonna be a one-time deal, but I think part of it was because it was cold in Minnesota and she had to get out of the snow too. Might be something to that. So take a look at this bathroom here. This bathroom was actually the closet in the master bedroom before. So why don't you go rewind to that and see that wonderful bathroom and closet. Cause that was a doozy. I think we should have kept it maybe. So, okay, last we're gonna go down the 3 bedrooms. First one on the right in the hallway. This is the bedroom, the biggest of the 3 bedrooms. We've got a big closet in here that used to be in the hallway. We got this bedroom here, we've taken out the seat. This was actually the bedroom that had that big furniture unit in. And this thing was, it just looked so gaudy in here and you had no room to move around. I think they were using it as an office. We put Canadian clear maple solid wood floor in here. Again, glued down, so this stuff ain't gonna ever move. We've built aprons on the windows. Every window in the house has been changed. Every door in the house has been changed. They're all Pella, Energy Star, so they're all really good quality stuff. Closet doors in here are all bifolds instead of the old mirrored border ones. LED lighting, ceiling fan in every single room. Every room was painted, new baseboard, new casing, and a ceiling fan in every room. So here's one of the rooms. Kind of looks like the boys, what would be the boys' room. So let's go into the little girls' room, or could be a boys' room or whatever, but decorated as a girls' room. So again, mom did all the decorating in here, all the staging. So give her a shout out for that when you see her next time. So in here, all the curtains and stuff were done. All the rooms are pretty much done the same. All the bedrooms have the maple flooring in them. It's a lighter floor, so it makes the room, even though it's not super small, it makes it look brighter and bigger because of it. And same thing in here, ceiling fan, lighting, the closet was done. All the doors are done. We'll take a look at those doors. We'll talk about those later. In a third bedroom, at the end of the hallway, and we're showing it as a office, but it's got a closet, so it counts as a bedroom. So this house ends up being 4 bedrooms, 3 baths. I thought this was a good room to use as a office, and that's how we're showing it. It used to have, we can go back to this, it used to have a sliding door going out to the front yard, which was, everybody kind of wondered why that was. And we found out later why that was, is because they cut off part of the house here and rented it to somebody. And that was his entrance into the thing. So in here, there also is in this closet a built-in safe. They took the owner before me, spent a lot of money, put an in-ground safe, cemented it all in. We left it, got the accommodation all redone and stuff. So you put all your big piles of money in there and gold doubloons. So we're coming to the bathroom that was one of the best bathrooms I've ever seen. Do you remember? It was floor to ceiling tile, and I'm sure they robbed a tile truck or something, because it was the same tile. They had so much of the same tile, it was ridiculous. All the way to the floor, ceiling, they had a sort of a tub spa thing, you know, like 1970s. We've tore up everything again in here, put in a regular bathtub, and retiled it floor to the ceiling, subway tile on the main wall, granite carving, you know, it's a quartz countertop with a new vanity, new toilet, every fixture, the fans, the painting, and well, look at Mom did it, this one right here. Everybody seems to like this curtain here. It is a, well, it started out to be a towel, but she made it into a window covering. Here's the, I think, the best part of this whole house. We're gonna go into the master bedroom. We have doubled the size of the master bedroom, and it's probably one of the coolest master bedrooms, well, I've ever seen. I would like to live here if I could, but unfortunately, I've already got a house. We're gonna sell this one, and we'll have to do another rock the house after this. So come on in this master, twice as big as it used to be. We put a built-in unit. I don't know who has a built-in unit like this in their bedroom and stuff, but you could put your wine in here and storage for everything. We have put carpet in this room. I believe every master bedroom should have carpet in it. It shouldn't have hardwood floors, softer feel, but we've put a tile that matches the tile in the master bathroom around the whole border. Easy to keep clean, looks cool, and it also let us do an entrance where the rear yard has a slider. So the slider goes into the rear yard, and we put this cool makeup counter in here, which anybody will appreciate. Even people with long hair. If you know any people who got long hair that need a makeup counter, this is what we're using for our hair and makeup department during this whole entire video series. So check that out. Storage over here, a little makeup mirror, magnified. We got a mirror that will tilt. Kind of like your own little hair studio here. So in here, check it out. Get a backup and pan up shot of this bedroom, because it is huge. You could put a couch in here. We got room for the TV on this barnwood wall. Oh, we didn't talk about the barnwood wall. So in here, the whole wall here is a barnwood wall. We got a barnwood door that will slide close to the master, to the bathroom. We've got a big spot where I've left enough room for like maybe a 75 or 65 inch TV here. We've also, in this wall, I did this my first time on this, I built some little niches into the wall. You can put some stuff in there. Just little features on this stuff that I've never done before, but I think they turned out pretty good. So get a backup of this wall, and we will go into the master bathroom. So got the barn door slider and this master bathroom. So same flooring continues throughout. It's, again, it's seamless. You got two vanities in here. The countertops in the bathroom and the vanity outside here, or the makeup counter, are an astro black quartz. All the hardware is all matte black. So you'll see the door hardware, the sinks, faucets, towel bars, all the fixtures in the bathroom, all in a matte black finish. That's the latest thing right now. So everything's matte black. It used to be brushed nickel, then it went to oil rub bronze. It's matte black. So we got the latest stuff in here. Check out this shower. So again, frameless shower doors, big thick 3/8 glass. Shaved rock on the floor with a modern drain, two seats in it. You got a rainhead shower, which I'm kind of tempted to turn it on right now because the camera guy is standing in the shower. I should do that. I should turn it on, because here, let me get that. But it's got body sprayers in here. It's got a handheld, a wand, and a rain head. And again in here, I did a couple different niches in here. One for shampoo, one for soap. This shower, I mean, you can fit four people in here if you feel like it's necessary, but let's just say two in here. So, all right, so that's that. We added on a separate toilet area. So that's completely private with a pocket door. Here we go. And again, so you saw that door. We customized all the doors in this house with a paint job that matches the front. And we'll back up and you can see that one. So here's the rest of the backup here with the rest of the bathroom. So we got another vanity and the lighting in here, and the barn wood goes and wraps all the way around from the master all the way around into the bedroom. So it kind of ties it all in. Off of the master bathroom, we did the master closet, which I think is better than having a closet off the master bedroom, because this is where you get ready. Get ready in here. You can shut this off, have the master bedroom separate. The floor in this bathroom is heated. It has a thermostat on. You can program it so it'll come on in the morning when you get up. It'll heat up the temperature of the floor, whatever you want it to. You come in here barefooted and the floor is nice and warm. So that's another feature that we did there. And then we come and look at the master closet, which is, we just left it pretty basic right now. I think people will kind of customize it. We have a little shelf in here, another storage in here. And again, LED lighting, the same floor that throughout the house goes through. So we will pan, we're gonna take a little break. We're gonna go out to the outside and check it out. Hey guys, remember this walk? Check this out, house is done. Now you get to see the whole thing. We're gonna see the whole outside. Everybody who's been on this thing from the very beginning, thank you so much for hanging with us the whole time. This is not the end. This is just the end of this project. We're gonna go on to another project. Hopefully we have bigger and better things. Maybe we're gonna have a really good professional cameraman that does some editing on something other than his Macintosh little computer or his iPhone. No, really, thank you to Jarvis too, because Jarvis has worked so hard on this thing. You can see all the good work that he's done, how great it is. And if you guys need contact information for Jarvis, the guy that's done all the filming, all the editing, the posting and everything, we'll put his information on at the very end too. So, but let's check out the house here. We got this driveway all done. We tore out the whole driveway, put brand new pavers in, the whole thing. We have not sealed it yet, so it'll look better when it's done. But check out this garage door.
Hey! How are you doing? Not only does this rock the house, this is rock the garage. Who wouldn't want a garage like this? You caught me, Mom. So, we did this garage completely over, tore it out, rewired it, outlets all the way around, drywalled, textured it, put this curb in, put the floor in.
Hey, are we dancing or something? Cause we're.
Oh, I was rocking out. So, check out this garage. I mean, wouldn't anybody be proud to have this garage like this, this floor? So, anyways. Did you get to check out the garage door too? We'll check that out in a second. But here, check out this, going from the garage into the kitchen here. We got the laundry room, I don't know if we went through that. So we got this, come into here, goes right into the kitchen. So
we did the garage door, same way we did the interior doors. And I gotta give a shout out to Pega. Pega's one who put the final touches on this thing. My friend, but she's probably mad at me because I didn't let her bring her boyfriend to the job while she worked. So thanks anyways, Pega. Good job. So come on down here. Another person I gotta thank too, my friend Luke helped us out with all the flooring, all the rock work on the fireplace outside the house, all the wood flooring,
all the tile in all the bathrooms, countertops, everywhere. Luke has been my savior, man. He's been here since the beginning, showed up every day, worked his tail off. So thanks to Luke too. So here's the outside. Dad did all the landscaping you're gonna see. Flowers, all the bark work, pulled out every weed out of these things by hand. Did the whole outside over here with the flowers, and we did the Malibu lights here, and we got to put a fountain in here, and got a little chair here too. So Mom and Dad spent quite a few mornings here having their morning coffee on this chair. So again, thanks to Mom and Dad too. I mean, I couldn't do it without them. And you saw how much they work, and if you guys know my mom and dad, how hard they work and how dedicated they are. So thank you to them, and I love you guys. Okay, so we're gonna go check out the backyard too. Hey, you know, I haven't done a wrestler impersonation for a long time, so I'm gonna do one for you here. Can you dig it? And then this is where we'll do the spin-a-rooney.
The Intercontinental title, more times than we can keep track of.
Except, you know who that is? You can find the wrestler who does that, and you can put that in that video there. Let's go to the backyard. In the backyard, remember we tore down the patio? We put the room addition on. We got a new patio with all new, with pavers, a paver step. You see the brand new slider door, the windows. You see the room addition. We continue to sidewalk all the way down the side of the house here and into a door over here with the master bedroom. So you can go right from the master bedroom out to the backyard. We got some fruit trees here, a lemon tree. There's an orange tree over here. I guess that's a fig tree over there. Don't ask me what a fig tree is. I don't know what it is. But so this backyard was done all by my dad. My dad came down from Minnesota, did all the landscaping in the backyard. He also did the landscaping in the front yard, which we'll go to and check all that out. We're still waiting for grass to come in this backyard.
There's a step there.
And then there's a step there. So watch out for the step. So let's go check out the front yard now. So I guess this is gonna be the end, but this is not the end of the whole thing. So we're gonna start another project hopefully soon. Thank you for everybody who took this journey with me. And everybody who helped, if you're named or unnamed, thank you so much for helping on this project, whether it be with just painting or even just hanging out here and help cleaning up and stuff. I mean, everybody had a part to do with it. So thanks everybody. This is Matt with Rock the House with Matt saying goodbye. I am going to take about a week off for sure now, so you won't see me.
The worm.